Hi, everybody. I'm glad to see there's more than one person. I was worried, I will admit. All right, so thank you for joining me for today's session on leveraging activity categories. My goal over the next 15 minutes is to try to enable you to find ways to get some efficiencies in your time tracking and more organized billing and reporting. So who am I? I am Tanya. I'm a software developer here at Clio. I actually began my journey 3 years ago as a senior data migration specialist. I got to work with many firms, small to large, helping to onboard them into Clio, migrating their data from their previous software management, of course, into our products. Now, working directly with the data also allowed me insights into the ways that firms currently organize their time and expense activities. So today I'm going to talk with a brief description about what activity categories are. I'm then going to show you how they can help your firm to become more consistently accurate. I'll show you how highly flexible they are, and we'll conclude with me showing you exactly how they can be used to lead to more organized billing and reporting. Before we begin, take a look at the number on the screen now. 2.5 hours. According to the Legal Trends Report, that's the average number of hours an attorney bills out of their 8-hour day. That's 31% of your time being accounted for. Now, the good news is, according to the Legal Trends Report of 2022 released yesterday, that number's actually gone up to 2.6. So we're making an improvement. I'm hoping today, though, that I can show you that spending a little bit of time up front will help you to gain efficiencies, getting you back to the billable work that matters. So what are they? Activity categories. They're used when you're creating your time and your expense entries. They're used to capture frequently performed events with an associated rate. It could be hourly, flat fee. Now there's many benefits to them, some of which we'll talk about today. So first off, how can they be helping you as a firm to become more consistently accurate? What it comes down to is less typing and more selecting from presets. I'll show you what this looks like. On the screen now is two different examples of creating activities. On the left side, you see a time entry, and on the right, an expense entry. The boxes that you see highlighted in orange are the standardized pick lists that you'll choose from that include the activity categories you've created. Now, I want to highlight, if you look at the expense entry, you'll see that there's an expense type at the top, hard or soft costs. Now, to learn more about the expense type, I'm going to direct you to the Customer Success Center. But what I want to mention is that depending on which one of those is chosen, the preset list that you're shown is further filtered. So, using predefined categories does save time, but it also enables you to become more accurate with consistent naming. On the screen here is an example of a before and after of applying those activity categories. You'll notice on the left, there's spelling mistakes, punctuation issues. There's no grouping of similar activities, and there's inconsistent descriptions. I can tell you, from my time in migrations, I have seen phone call described about a million different ways. So hopefully, you guys can learn how to create these activity categories, and it'll help you to avoid some of these common errors that you see. So on the right side, with the activity categories, you'll notice it's cleaner, it's more organized. There's no spelling mistakes, there's less punctuation issues. And of course, they're grouped better. They're categorized, making it easier to filter on. Activity categories are very flexible as well. You can pre-assign a rate to the category, you can edit it on the go, and they work directly with Clio's billing rate hierarchy. I'll show you what this looks like. What you see now is an example of creating an activity category. The first thing to note is you choose the type, the rate type. It could be a user default rate, a flat rate, or a custom rate like you see on the screen now. As mentioned, these work directly with the billing rate hierarchy. So if you create an activity category with a custom rate, that will actually be overridden by any preset contact or matter rates that you have. However, on the flip side, if you create an activity category that has a flat rate, it'll supersede any of those predefined rates. Billing rate hierarchy has many levels. And again, if you'd like to learn more, I highly encourage you to talk to the Success Center and they'll be able to walk you through that. Now you'll see on the right-hand side, I've got a few of them highlighted in orange. The significance of this is that activity categories are a benefit, especially for those activities that you perform that have a different rate than your user default rate. So for example, my user default rate is $290 an hour. Well, at least I wish it was. But for this example, we'll go with that. The ones highlighted in orange, you can see have a rate different than that. So when the activity category is clicked on, that rate is automatically populated in for me. You'll notice there's also a no charge rate. The advantage to the no charge rate is that you can still show the activity on a bill, but of course, not bill for it, enabling you to share everything that you do for your matter with your clients. This can also be done with the flat rate activity category. So here we see the creation of a time entry using a flat fee activity category. The first thing I want to highlight is you'll note the duration field is actually grayed out. Now this is because it's a flat rate, which means that duration field is non-applicable, right? So when you're creating activity categories for flat fees, we recommend you do it for your most common flat fee activities. Now I emphasize most common because you don't want to be back to having inefficiencies sorting through a huge list, right? However, as you see on this screen, I have created one called a flat fee miscellaneous with, again, a zero rate, as you can see in the rate box there. The advantage to this one, you can still categorize any of those lesser performed activity categories as a flat fee. And when you create the activity, you just override that rate with the rate you want to charge. It allows you to still categorize it. You can filter on it. You can also assign visibility permissions to an activity category. Now, the default when you create one is that the activity category is available and visible to everybody. However, if you leverage groups and permissions at Clio, you can assign permissions to those categories, such as junior partners or associates, whatever it is. The one thing you can't see on the screen right now, because it's hidden by the dropdown, unfortunately, is that you can also make these available to co-counsel. So theoretically, you can create a set of activity categories for your co-counsel to use, and again, allowing you to easily run a report to filter on those. If you want to learn more about groups and permissions in Clio, I bet you think I'm going to say to go to the Success Center, right? But I'm not. The very next presentation here on the stage is how to set up permissions in Clio. Perfect. Okay, so I've talked a lot about activity categories, how they can benefit the global firm. However, there is an actual individual-based benefit as well. You can create something that's called a default time category. What I would recommend here is if you yourself perform a particular activity the most, set a new category for that, a time activity category. When you go to create a new time entry in Clio, it automatically populates to that for you, including your rate. Now, I know I say it saves time and it seems silly to say that with a single click. However, think of yourself entering the same activity over and over for your matters. You can see how that savings could add up. Here's how easy this is to set up. You'll navigate to the Activities tab, select Manage Categories, find the particular category you want to set, choose to edit, set as default. It's that easy. You'll see it's now flagged as your default category. When you create a new time entry, it's automatically populated there. You don't have to find it in your list, including the associated rate. You can, of course, change that default category at any time. So the last thing to talk about is how these categories can help you become more organized with your billing and reporting. On the screen now, if you were to, let's say, generate an activity report or even view your activities in your dashboard, you can easily filter them by choosing the filter button in the top right-hand corner and then navigating to the time or expense category you want to filter on. Simply run the report and it's filtered, and you just see the ones that you want to actually report on. Now, this is the fun part. They can be leveraged to streamline your billing as well. There's a feature in Clio when generating an invoice, which allows you to select a detail level of activity summary. When you select this, what it does is it takes all of the activities for that particular category, adds them all up, and you see it as a single line item on your bill. So it massively consolidates the bill down. Now, you do lose a bit of that detail, though. So it's really on a bill-to-bill basis as to what your preference is. But let me show you what this looks like and the difference between the two. So the first one we see here is before consolidating. It's very detailed. It's 3 pages long. But you see all of the activities you're choosing to bill for. The flip side to that, as I said, is running that report with that detail level set to activity summary. And it's massively consolidated down to a single bill. Now, these two examples were the exact same activities that were chosen to be reported on. So as mentioned, on an invoice-to-invoice basis, you can choose the detail level you want. So we're nearing the end of our time together, and I want to do a quick recap over what we talked about today. First off, using activity categories can help your firm to become more consistently accurate through consistent naming, right? Less spelling mistakes and punctuation issues. They're highly flexible. You can edit them on the go, pre-assign rates. And then, of course, you've seen how they can be used to have more organized billing and reporting. So what can you take away from this session? That's the question. I encourage you to take a look at your activities, your most commonly performed ones, and see if they have a dedicated rate. If so, great opportunity to create an activity category. And then using those activity categories can hopefully give you efficiencies back to get back time for the billable work that matters. Thank you very much, you guys. I've enjoyed speaking with you today, and I hope you're enjoying the conference. If you have any questions, please visit us at the Success Center as well.